the Sports Guys Championship Edition, live from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Picked up by Blair. Watkins penetrates, kicks Byers, baseline, off the glass, good. Cade Byers. Connor Roberts, inbound pass, battle, no-look pass, Rhodes, off the glass, good.
Nice pass, nice play by Rhodes.
Cross-court pass to Evan Rhodes, he'll launch, three on the way, yes sir. Evan Rhodes with five in the quarter. It's Roberts on the right wing, stops, pass underneath, Byers, layup good.
Boy, Byers having a big game early for Pikeville inside.
Chevrolet scoreboard, Pikeville the basketball, Rhodes underneath, Byers lays it in.
Nice pass, and I'm glad he elected to lay that in instead of trying to dunk it.
Right elbow, head fake, move, shot partially blocked, rebound Billiter. Rhodes, outlet ahead, Roberts, layup good. Connor Roberts with a basket. Long tip outside. Battle comes up with it. Runner in the lane. Finger roll is good.
Wow.
How in the world that did that one go?
Toughest shot of all of them, and that's the one that goes in. Ah, look at Baffert.
Grace in the lane. Blocked by Byers. Loose ball picked up Rice. Pass stolen. Here comes Wyatt Battle. Battle to the basket. Layup good.
Wasn't sure what was going to happen on that.
Battle comes off the screen. Battle pull up left elbow, jumper no good. Got his own rebound. Back up and in.
That'll do it.
Wyatt Battle with a basket. Puts down the baseline to Cade Byers. Back to Rhodes. Battle three ball on the way good. Wyatt Battle. Battle dribbles top of the key. Kicks it in the corner. Three on the way, no good. Billiter offensive rebound and the putback.
Big rebound by Christian Billiter.
Reset.
So he went right back up with it.
Watkins three ball, no. Rebound, Byers, yes.
What about the work by Christian Billiter, the sophomore on the boards, Jim?
2:05 to play in the third. Battle lost the handle near midcourt, got it back. Lob, Byers went up to get it, flashes back out Roberts. Up and in from downtown, Connor Roberts. Have a 9-point Pikeville lead. Cole Crace drives, no. Loose ball rebound, Cade Byers,
no,
and to Rhodes.
No.
Rhodes one-on-one with Davis. Hop step layup. Good.
Wow. Johnson Central needs a timeout.
5-11.
Boy, young man came in, gave the Panthers a spark. Byers, spin move. He has had the game of all games here tonight. 23 for Cade Byers. Back tap by Watkins. Picked up.
Pass.
Billiter to the basket. Yes.
Oh, what a move.
Christian Billiter.
Billiter is too.
Yep. Three ball for Blair, 9 points. Rhodes, no look, Byers, yes.
What a pass. Evan Rhodes to Byers.
The ball right in front of us. Pass to Watkins. Watkins underneath, Byers,
wow.
Yes.
What a pass.
Ahead to Rhodes to Watkins. 6-point Pikeville lead. Watkins gets in the paint, back to Rhodes. He'll launch, three ball, yes. Evan Rhodes with a triple. Watkins with a basketball. Picks it up, kicks in the corner. Evan Rhodes, three ball. Corner pocket is good.
Wow.
Panther basketball. Roberts inbounds to Evan Rhodes. Rhodes splits the defenders. Two on ones to the basket. That's a block and a bucket. Evan Rhodes. Battle bump. Official's not going to call it now. Reisner, Rhodes, 2 seconds. Underneath the senior, Mikey McDonald at the buzzer. Final score on the Hutch Chevrolet scoreboard, Pikeville 95, Johnson Central 84. And again, the Panthers are going to party like it's 1999 tonight. Wow. Unbelievable. 95-84, Pikeville, your 2017 15th region champions.
Hello everyone, and welcome to a special edition of the Sports Guys. It's a championship edition as we come to you live from Buffalo Wild Wings and Pikeville on EKB TV and the stations of East Kentucky Broadcasting. It goes without saying, a special edition when the Sports Guys are in the house somewhere in our area. Something big has happened, and guys, we saw it happen on Monday night. Pikeville winning the 15th region championship, And, of course, it's a big deal when his team wins a regional championship. And it's a bigger deal when it's almost 20 years between those regional championships. Pikeville, of course, as you know, the last time it happened, 1999. Welcome in. We've got players to talk to tonight as we celebrate the Panthers' 15th region championship. The trophy is on display in front of us, along with the basketball as well. And I'm not sure which basketball this is, but it's got some signatures on it. Jim, Jamie, Frosty, have you guys been busy?
Slightly.
Okay. I noticed you had Sharpie on your fingers, so you've been signing autographs as well. We've got a lot of fans on hand tonight as well, enjoying the atmosphere here at Buffalo Wild Wings. And things have gone crazy for this Pikeville basketball program since Monday night. They hadn't won a regional championship in basketball in nearly 20 years, and to celebrate that and start making preparations for Rupp Arena is a huge deal. It is the Sports Guys in the house from Buffalo Wild Wings. We'll talk with players, coaches, maybe some fans as well. A lot of maroon in the house here at Buffalo Wild Wings, and you have time to join us this evening. We're joined by a panel of Sports Guys, and we'll be joined by the coach and players coming up tonight from Buffalo Wild Wings. But first, we go round the horn as we do with the Sports Guys, special edition or not. Ladies and gentlemen, the Duke of Drift, Jamie Johnson.
I'm the only sports guy that hasn't eaten yet. Did you do it?
There's two of us.
Okay.
I'm looking at this batch.
We're both looking at this batch of wings. I haven't touched a thing. These two gentlemen to my right have hammered down over the last 20 minutes. I mean, I'm impressed. I was thoroughly impressed with how good you guys took those wings so fast. I mean, it was just unreal. I mean, almost as fast as Pikeville getting up and down the court on Monday night. Who knew Pikeville had so much speed? And I don't think a lot of their opponents – yeah, I'm sure you guys did, but I don't think the opponents knew how fast that team could play. I didn't. Watching them earlier in the season, a totally different team. And was thoroughly impressed with their run here in the postseason. Just a fantastic job by Pikeville High School.
It's an interesting point, and it's almost as if Pikeville was a thoroughbred horse that had been in training, and the jockey had been holding that horse back until the appropriate moment in a horse race. And it seemed like Pikeville did that. They had an opponent they felt like they could run with, and Johnson Central, I'm not sure many people had thought to try that route, but the Panthers certainly showed some speed. And then they made baskets. And when you make baskets, you're going to be successful. 68% in the second half from the 15th region championship. It's tough for anyone to knock off a team that gets on that kind of run. And I'm going to use Frosty Davis's favorite term, momentum. It built yes. with the Panthers. And when you get that kind of momentum, regardless if you were down 18, that kind of momentum carries over to every player that's on the floor. When a team gets hot, a player gets hot, it's contagious.
You know, you look back at the first game they played against Belfry when the tournament began in the quarterfinals, and you're not too impressed with what Pikeville did that night. Score only in the 60s. It wasn't anything to look at and say, oh, they look like champs. It didn't look that way. They get into the South Floyd game. They're down by 6 in the fourth quarter. What happens? Lightning in a bottle. Wyatt Battle hits shots. Evan Rhodes, he hits shots. Things start to happen. You just said it. You hit shots, good things are going to happen.
Yeah.
And they were hitting shots well defended. That team had a 2-3 zone against Pikeville. They're hitting threes from the volleyball line at times. Evan Rhodes, he caught fire as well in that game. Kyle Watkins hit some key threes. They were 9 of 13 in the second half of that game. If you're going to shoot 9 of 13 from three and South Floyd shot 58%, hey, look at it, threes and twos. You see why Pikeville won that game and didn't go on to the championship. And the hot shooting continued, down by 18, rallied to 8 by the half, and then a 33-12 run in the third quarter.
Boom.
And I think it goes back to putting the team on the floor that can run and not afraid to do it. Some teams look at a team like a Johnson Central and say, oh, we can't run with them.
Right.
You look at Pikeville's stats for the year and their offensive stats, you know, they were only averaging in the 60s. So for them to be in the 70s and 80s was a little bit outside of their norm unless they were, you know, they had some games where they did that, but it was against subpar competition. To do that against teams and challenge the ones that were supposed to be favorites and beat them, that was very impressive, and a kudos to them.
Be honest, guys, who thought that the 15th region championship game
would be one team in the 80s and the other team in the 90s.
Not at all.
Not regulation.
I don't think any of us would have predicted that for a game that ended in four quarters and not overtime or double overtime or triple overtime when your scores can get elevated. 95-84, the Panthers win it, and I think they surprised a lot of people. Maybe not being there, maybe not being in the Final Four or even in the finals. We talked about that prior to the postseason, that any team in that tournament could have a shot to win it.
Yes,
yeah, there were a couple of teams that were favorites, but we also sensed that there was a team or two that was getting hot at the right time. Pikeville was one of those teams that we had talked about. That's Jamie Johnson, and also joined by part of the championship game broadcast team, Jim Williamson. You're a Pikeville guy.
Yes, sir.
You don't hold that close to the vest.
No.
People know that. And you recall the 1999 championship.
I remember the 99. There's been three since I've been alive. And I remember the 74 group. So this, it was special to me to get to call that. And like you said, you know, I wasn't surprised it was Pikeville Johnson Central in the finals. But, man, when that game got going and you could tell where the score was leading to, a 90s to 80s game in regulation surprised me. And we already talked about the speed, the quickness. I think that's the two quickest teams in the 15th region.
Yeah.
And just sitting there getting to watch those two teams go up and down was amazing.
A horse race, and I don't think anybody's surprised Wyatt Battle, one of the top players in the 15th region. You expect him to go out and get you 20 points. He averages nearly that. 25 points, not terribly surprised. You've got Evan Rhodes, a player Frosty Davis has raved about, said this kid can play. And he's going to break out. He had 22. But I think the big surprise was Cade Byers.
Yeah.
What a breakout game at the most appropriate time a high school player can have to break out and score 28 in the 15th region championship on the big stage, under the bright lights, in front of a huge crowd. Cade Byers, the biggest surprise in that game.
Andrew, I looked at it today. The young man scored in double figures four games this year. 12 was his high.
Right.
Shows up for the regional final and goes for 28. And the stats, official stats didn't show it. We're pretty sure he had a double-double.
And fouled out.
And fouled
out. More.
Yeah. And, yeah, I mean, there was still, what, 3 or 4 minutes left in the game. Just an incredible show, along with Battle and Rhodes. Byers just did a tremendous job. And it won't show, but when Byers went out, Christian Billiter came in and kept that same position productive, and your role players really stepped up.
You look up and down the lineup for Pikeville of the players in the 15th region championship game. Kyle Watkins gave you plays that you needed to be able to get a win. Battle, of course. Rhodes, of course. Connor Roberts was so solid throughout the entire. Mr. Consistency. Then Byers, Reisner, and Billiter also contributing in ways that maybe don't show up in the box score. And then you've got the senior Mikey McDonald. He doesn't get left out as well. He's there for the final minutes. He's on the big stage, and one of your seniors gets there and is in the highlight package as well. It was a total team effort. Yeah, you had some big performances. You're going to have those to win a championship regardless of the sport, regardless of the level. But if you don't get that team play, that consistency up and down from everyone, Pikeville doesn't win that game.
Yeah, and some of the best passing I've seen. This was a tremendous regional tournament overall to me, but we saw some of the best passing that night I've seen all year.
Pikeville wins the 15th region championship. Frosty Davis, you're another one of those guys that's been around for three of Pikeville's trips to the Sweet 16. Of course, back in the early 70s.
Freedom Hall.
The Freedom Hall. Mm-hmm. And then of 99 in Rupp Arena. And now in 2017, Pikeville makes a return trip to the state tournament after their last trip in 1999. And you don't want to look too far ahead. You want to celebrate what's in front of you. But Pikeville's got a lot returning as well.
Yeah, they do. You know, Connor Reisner and Mikey McDonald, the only two seniors on the team. And both of them, they play key roles all year long. Reisner, this is great to see him do so well this year. Had to sit out all last year due to knee surgery from a soccer injury. So didn't even get to play his junior year. So I was really just tickled to death to see Connor Reisner out there and how well he's done. He had a huge charge in that ball game, and that's one of his things that he's very, very good at. Mikey McDonald, just a great, great athlete. You've got some really good athletes on this basketball team
sure.
that play other sports, and I think that, you know, and I'm a, you know, all-sport guy, football, baseball, basketball, whatever. But I think that really helps out there, especially in those tough games.
Absolutely. And, of course, it's a Sports Guys special edition, a championship edition, as we celebrate the Panthers' 15th region basketball championship. They head to Rupp Arena next Wednesday. Of course, we'll be there. But the Sports Guys, when we get together, it's March Madness. Not just the Pikeville Panthers, but also the UPike Bears. And, Jamie, we've got a special production lined up for tomorrow night, both the men and women heading to national tournaments.
Hey, we're eating here two nights in a row. Goodbye tomorrow night, UPike. And, of course, the men and the women, they'll be here tomorrow night. And the women go to Big Sky Country, going to Montana. Ooh. I actually wouldn't mind getting that assignment, but I understand. I understand. But the women go out there, and, of course, the men will be going to Kansas City. And we'll talk with Kelly and Coach Williams, and we'll see how they're ready to go. And hopefully a good showing for UPike in the NAIA tournament. Once again, the women last year in the Fab Four, and we know what the men can do in the past, so let's hope for a good showing.
Absolutely. Of course, the men, they're accustomed to being in Kansas City. They know the surroundings. They know the ins and outs of that tournament. It's all new for the women, but you've got an experienced team coming off that Final Four appearance last year in the NAIA women's tournament, a new coach, and a team that's peaking at the right time. We'll find out if the Kentucky Wildcats are peaking at the right time as well, or do they simply slide through the SEC tournament waiting for the NCAA tournament brackets. The SEC tomorrow, Kentucky in action, 1 o'clock. And does Kentucky change their seeding if they were to win the tournament?
You got to wonder. I mean, you look today, Duke beating Louisville, that's going to hurt Louisville's seeding. I think as long as you're good through the first couple of games and you get to the title game, you're going to secure whatever seed you're – the highest ceiling of a seed you're going to get. Kentucky has to play well tomorrow versus Georgia. Georgia's had Kentucky's number two times and have been able to use a lie for two of those nine
That's right.
to get around it. Will they have another one coming up? We're going to find out tomorrow. You know, Georgia's back healthy again. J.J. Frazier didn't play very well today, but he'll be on his game tomorrow. Of course, Martine, he is back healthy for them. That'll poise a problem for Kentucky tomorrow. But I think the Cats are the best they can do, in my opinion, is a two seed. If they win the entire tournament and win the next three games.
Sure.
But 2-3 seed at best for Kentucky.
Yeah, the NCAA tournament looks to be a great tournament as well. And, of course, we'll talk about that again Monday with the Sports Guys as the brackets will have been released at that point. And we'll catch you up to date on that and all things sports. It is the Sports Guys Championship Edition. We are live from Buffalo Wild Wings, as you may be able to see. We've got the waiters and waitresses. They care less about cameras. They're going
to
walk through
work to do.
Our shot. They've got work to do. They're feeding a lot of Pikeville fans here at Buffalo Wild Wings. The players are here. The coaches are here. Moms, dads, grannies, grandpas, uncles, aunts, cousins, cheerleaders, dance team members, they're all here celebrating this Pikeville Panther team as they prepare to move to Rupp Arena next week to represent the 15th region. We'll talk with the players and the coach of your Pikeville Panthers, the 15th region champion, Elisha Justice, first-year coach at Pikeville, coming up next. It's a Panthers championship edition of the Sports Guys. We're back right after this.
More new cars, more new trucks, more certified vehicles. That's the Hutch Chevrolet Advantage. At Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC, you can take advantage of over 300 vehicles in stock, pre-owned cars and trucks, starting at under $10,000. On Hutch Certified Pre-Owns, you receive an exclusive 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance plan, 2 manufactured-backed warranties, and 24/7 roadside assistance. What are you waiting for? Start shopping now at HutchAutoGroup.com and come see us at Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC in Paintsville.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th region tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
El Azul Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Rodney Scott and the Pike County Sheriff's Department congratulate the Pikeville Panthers, 15th Region Tournament champs. Good luck at the Sweet 16 Tournament, Panther Pride.
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th Region Tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Welcome back in. It's the Sports Guys Championship Edition celebrating a Pikeville 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship. Of course, Monday night, the Panthers defeated Johnson Central 95-84 to punch a ticket to Rupp Arena. And joined now by the head coach of your Panthers, Elisha Justice, no stranger to 15th Region Championships, but your first as a head coach. What's the feeling like Monday night?
Well, I told Coach Boer walking off the floor, I said, you know, it's a lot different. I said, I think I've enjoyed it more as a coach and than as a player. But it's, you know, it's just amazing, you know, to see these guys and, you know, the excitement on them. You know, the season that they've had, they've continued to get better every single day. And just for them to know that what they've worked for all year, it's been great for them.
Of course, you work with your old coach, Jason Boer, and he was in coaching a few years before he got his first championship. You know, you've done it in a relatively short amount of time. Do you rub that in on him a little?
Well, I just told him, I said, you're better as just an assistant than a head coach is what I told him. But I've got to give him a hard time. He sure does to me. But
I guarantee you.
No, it's great. You know, just having him there and the experience that he has that I don't have yet as a coach, you know, he's been a big help to me, him and Coach Newsom both have.
Absolutely. A lot of experience there helping you on the sidelines with this Pikeville team. Elisha, we've talked about surprise performances. No surprise that you were in the championship game. We had talked about it prior to the postseason beginning that there were a handful of teams that could win this 15th region. Whoever showed up, whoever played well, whoever peaked at the right time. Has your team peaked?
Well, you know, everybody always says that. You know, you want to peak at the right time. And when you look at our season, you know, right after the All-A, you could see a change in our guys. And I think that's, you know, we started to really start getting better. It was after that. Started with the Belfry game on the road. And from that point on, you just seen like a different team. And they looked better every single game, I felt like. And starting from that point, I can't remember the exact amount. I think it was 15 out of 17 that we won starting after the All-A. And, you know, and I kept saying it going into the district tournament. Then I kept saying it going into the regional tournament, we're playing our best basketball right now. You know, and I think everybody's seen that, you know, in that championship game.
What we talked about in the opening segment, none of us would have predicted a score with a team in the 90s and a team in the 80s unless it had gone to overtime. We didn't expect that kind of score. Johnson Central, obviously, they can put up a bunch of points, but we really hadn't seen that track meet kind of play out of Pikeville up until that moment. It's almost as if you had this team held back and said, all right, guys, second half, let's go out and get it.
Yeah, Johnson Central, they're different than every other team that we played in this region, and we knew that going in. They played at a faster pace
sure.
than anybody I've seen. And we knew that they were going to run, that they were great in transition, they were going to press, and we had to handle their pressure. You know, and we made a few mistakes early in the first half and dug ourselves a hole. But then it was like in the second half, these guys just started attacking that press. And, you know, and we played at that same pace, and we started getting layups, you know. And and somehow just had to figure out how to get a few stops on the other end of the floor, and which was extremely difficult when you look at Johnson Central and the way they shoot the basketball.
Did it remind you any of your playing days at Shelby Valley, because your team scored a lot of points the same way, beating pressure?
Yeah, and we also pressed a lot ourselves, and, yeah. And that's another thing. Me and Boer was talking. We was trying to think. We said, did we ever score that many points in a regional championship? And,
right.
And I don't think we did. It was at a faster pace, I felt like. Obviously, we like to get up and down, but we also knew when to slow it down and run a little bit of clock as well.
You've had a couple of days for this to sink in, the championship Monday night, and it starts to sink in. What's this week been like for you as a head coach? What kind of demands have you seen?
Well, these guys, I mean, they're just enjoying it right now. You know, we've been celebrating, and, you know, everybody's just having a good time at school and congratulating the guys, and they deserve that. And, you know, we're just, you know, now we're just trying to tell the guys that, you know, we're not finished yet. You know, we want to go to state, and, you know, we got Perry Central, and we feel like we can win, and, you know, and we're not going down there content and satisfied with the 15th region title. And, you know, we're going down there to play and compete.
Of course, Perry Central played non-central for the 14th region championship. Did you guys have a chance to see that?
Yeah, we took the team over, and we watched that championship game just so the guys could kind of get a feel for who they're going to be playing and get to see them in live action. So it's a little bit different than seeing it on film.
Sure. And last time you walked out of Rupp Arena, do you remember when that was?
As a high school player in 2010, state champion. So, you know, I've been looking forward to getting an opportunity to go back and compete in the Sweet 16 as a coach. And, you know, I'm just thrilled and thankful to have that opportunity this year.
Absolutely. And, of course, one of your old friends, your old coach, he'll be walking with you with a great group of young men that are called the 15th Region Basketball Champions. No pressure on you. Enjoy this one and enjoy the Sweet 16. But we look at your roster now, and we start looking down the road a year from now. You've got a lot of kids coming back.
Yeah, we return our starting five, which is huge, you know. And these guys, I think it's good that they've got the experience now of winning a 15th Region Championship. And get to go down and get a taste of the state tournament, I think is going to be great for them. And, you know, and they're going to come back, and these guys, they're going to work, and they're going to be excited, and they're, you know, they want to make a run next year as well.
Absolutely. Elisha Justice, congratulations on a 15th region championship. There are so many coaches that dream of a trip to the Sweet 16 that never get there, and you've done it early in your career. I think that says something about your coaching ability and some coaches that you've played for in the years, giving you that experience early on in your career. Great job.
Well, I appreciate it. And like you said, I've had great coaches helping me, and I've got a great group of guys that's worked extremely hard for this. So.
Absolutely. It doesn't come easily. That's why you celebrate championships. Elisha Justice, head coach of the Panthers, good luck. Next Wednesday, we'll be right there for the ride.
Thank you. Appreciate you guys.
It's the Sports Guys Championship Edition, celebrating a 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship with the Pikeville Panthers, coming to you live from Buffalo Wild Wings with a lot of Panther fans, the players here as well. And you'll meet some of those players coming up when the Sports Guys Championship Edition returns right after this.
Epic Escape Game Pikeville would like to congratulate PHS on their win in the 15th Region Tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at State from all of us at Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th Region Tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
El Azul Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Welcome back into Buffalo Wild Wings. Frosty Davis in with Jim Williamson. We have the two long senior members of the 15th Regional Champion Pikeville Panthers, Connor Eisner and Mikey McDonald. And guys, first of all, congratulations on that big win and your 15th regional championship against Johnson Central.
I really appreciate it. Thank you. Appreciate it.
To start with you, Connor, and I've talked about you all year, and just a little while ago, it just tickles me to death to see you having a great year, senior year, after having set out last year. Tell us what happened in that soccer game and why you had to sit out last year.
The ball was coming to me, and I just stepped and it tore. Just one wrong step and it tore, and that ruined my hope next year.
And then you had surgery and had to sit out your entire junior year.
Yep. When I came back this year, I'm just glad that we got it done. I really am. It's unbelievable.
Good deal. Mikey, of course, you play football and baseball as well. And Jim Williamson came up with a little stat today that I don't think a whole lot of people knew, and I didn't even realize it. You want to share that with Mikey?
There's only 8 Pikeville players in history that have played in a football state championship game and a basketball state tournament game. And you guys, there's 4 of you on this team, could be the only 4 to win a game in each one.
Yeah, Lucas was explaining that to me earlier.
Yeah.
I talked to him about it. It's pretty crazy.
It is. Only 8 people in the history of Pikeville. And I'll go one step further. There's only 1 family in the history of Pikeville that has played in a state baseball tournament.
Basketball
and football. Your brother took care of the baseball part.
Yeah.
Did you think about that?
I didn't know about
that. So the McDonald family is the only family that's been in all 3.
That's true. I hadn't thought about that. Excellent point.
John and Paul would be proud, I tell you. Mikey, you've had a pretty good year as well this year. How did it feel winning that 15th Region Championship Monday night?
Oh, it felt great. It was wonderful just watching the team, knowing how hard they worked and stuff, just like their success and stuff. It was wonderful. I enjoyed it.
Listen, we just mentioned you played in the state football championship last year. Big stage, not Rupp Arena.
Yeah.
But do you think that prepares you for what you're going to run into when you go down there Wednesday?
Yeah, I think so. Just having that experience and being in championship games and bigger stages will just play a role.
Yeah. Connor, you had to draw a charge Monday night.
Every game.
As soon as you did, our play-by-play guy, J.D. Hughes, said, Connor Eisner does what Connor Eisner
that's
does.
That's right. That's right.
That was a huge, huge defensive play in that ball game.
Thank you. I appreciate it. That's my thing. I love them.
And I'm pretty sure, and I might even have said this on the radio, that you were probably thinking about that when that guy was about 80 feet from you when he started your
run. Right when he caught the ball, I knew he was putting his head down. He's going to run right over me to get the basket.
And you were sitting there waiting on
him. I was.
Tell us, guys, starting back in the summer and what you guys did this summer in summer ball, and then, practice, and then take us through the season a little bit, some of the highlights. And did you ever imagine that you'd be sitting here right now talking to us about the 15th Regional Championship? Mikey, we'll start with you.
I missed a lot of the summer due to other sports.
Right, that's okay.
But when I first started practice, I knew we had a special team. Mm-hmm. I knew we had a lot of people, a lot of talent, especially with, like, a point guard like Kyle. I saw his ability to handle the ball. And then, like, we had shooters in the corners like Connor. Mm-hmm. And then we had, like, an all-around athlete like Wyatt could just pretty much take over at any point. Mm-hmm. And I knew that we had a lot of depth too, so I figured we could have a big run in the region and even win it.
Connor, you've been with them. I don't know if you got to play much this summer. You're still healing up, but to take us through the practices and this year, some of your thoughts and some of the games that you're
I believe the practices that we've had this year has helped us a lot. Like, just all the things he just knows. Like, I don't know. It's just he just knows what to do and, like, tell us to do. And the drills just get us prepared. And, like, his scouting, that's what helps us a lot, in my opinion. We know what we're going to do and what we need to do to get the win.
Do y'all focus more on what the other team does and how you need to defend them or maybe how you need to attack them, or do you focus more on what your team's going to do?
It's a little bit of both, I think.
It's a lot to do with the other team, though, because like all the experience the coaches have and knowing what to do, it helps a lot because they tell us exactly what the other team's going to do, and it just keeps us mentally focused and ready for the game, too, so it helps a lot.
Well, let me ask you, too. You guys are seniors. New coach this year, new system. When did you all feel like it kicked in for you guys and you had to quit thinking and just automatically started playing the way he wanted you to play?
I would say probably about halfway through the season. It took a little bit to get – it's like playing time was down, but, I mean, I think it's better, though.
Right.
Like, yeah.
Yes. And, guys, being seniors, you'll be heading off next year. And of course, we got some business to take care of next week. But tell us your all's plans after your senior year in college or armed services or work. What's your plans, guys?
I plan to attend college like Eastern Kentucky or University of Kentucky. I'm not sure yet, but major in biology and try to become a physical therapist or something that way.
Good deal.
Yeah, I plan on going to the University of Kentucky, major in biology, and try to become a dentist.
Are you?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you what, if neither one of those careers work out for you, I think either one of you could be broadcasters.
Yeah.
No nerves here.
No hesitation.
Really, really well.
Yep.
Jim, got any more questions?
Nah, I mean, just wish you guys good luck. I know it's a big stage, 23,000-seat arena. You guys earned this trip. And that was a big win against the best team in the region until you guys showed who was the best team. Just wish y'all good luck.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
And you all know I'm your biggest fan.
That's right.
I'll be right in there with you. All right. That's seniors Connor Eisner and Mikey McDonald. We'll be back with more from Buffalo Wild Wings. This is EKB TV.
More new cars, more new trucks, more certified vehicles. That's the Hutch Chevrolet Advantage. At Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC, you can take advantage of over 300 vehicles in stock, pre-owned cars and trucks, starting at under $10,000. On Hutch Certified Pre-Owns, you receive an exclusive 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance plan, 2 manufactured-backed warranties, and 24/7 roadside assistance. What are you waiting for? Start shopping now at HutchAutoGroup.com and come see us at Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC in Paintsville.
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th region tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Thacker Memorial congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the 15th region tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16. Way to go, Panthers!
Rustic Roots on 2nd congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the 15th region tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16. Go Panthers!
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at state from all of us at Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
It's the Sports Guys Championship Edition as we celebrate the Pikeville Panthers 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship. As you have seen, the National Championship cheerleaders, they'll be making an appearance in Rupp Arena as well next week along with this Panther basketball team. And we celebrate tonight. We've talked with head coach Elisha Justice.
You'll have a chance to meet the players tonight, coming to you live from Buffalo Wild Wings. A lot of Panther fans are in the house, the cheerleaders, the dance team, a lot of alumni, Frosty.
Uh-huh.
We have seen some alums of Pikeville here as well. It's been 18 years since the Panther faithful has had a chance to celebrate a championship, and one reason for that is our next guest, the MVP of the 15th Region Tournament, Wyatt Battle, joins us. Wyatt, welcome in. Congratulations.
Thank you.
What a tremendous tournament you have, and not really surprised by that. You've had a pretty solid season. But heading into the 15th Region Tournament, you guys hadn't played Johnson Central. Obviously, you knew you had a tough road to get there. Belfry and South Lloyd, both worthy opponents. Then you get the championship with Johnson Central. You had not played them, and you guys went fast. But tell us your feelings, your thoughts about what it felt like when you were down 18 points in the first half. What was the mood like?
It was really a rough feeling, honestly, because – you come out with all this game plan of how we're going to play defense and stuff, and then they come out and really they just hit tough shots. I mean, we weren't playing too bad a defense. They just had players – they had good players making tough shots. So when you're down 18, we know we always got a chance to come back because we got shooters too.
Sure.
So we're just going to keep playing as hard as we can, hopefully pick up the pace like we did, and I think we did a pretty good job.
Job indeed. We were a little surprised by the pace and the fact that this game ended up 95-84, both teams in the 80s and 90s. We were a little taken aback by that. Not surprised by your play. We've come to expect that. Many throughout the region have expected. Wyatt Battle, he'll have a big night. He's Mr. Consistency. And then you get good play from your teammate Evan Rhodes as well. The entire team contributed. But how about Cade Byers? Were you surprised by his breakout game?
No. I know what he's capable of. He's a great player. People don't always see him score as much, but he blocks shots, he gets rebounds, he does everything else. So he was due for a big night, and he just stepped up when he had to.
Wyatt, you've had a chance to play in the state championship game in football. Now you head to the state tournament in basketball. There's a small group of Pikeville players of different sports over the years that have been able to do that. What's that feeling like as you now know you're heading to Rupp Arena?
It's a great feeling. It was a tremendous feeling to go to state and win it my sophomore year as quarterback, and now I get the chance to do it my junior year in basketball. It's just really a blessing. I got to thank everybody that's a part of it, my teammates and my coaches, because it's all one big family here.
Hey, Wyatt, I know you play a lot of basketball in the summer on the AAU circuit, and, of course, you know, summer ball is your team as well. Any of the guys that you play with or played against this summer, are they going to be down at the state tournament playing?
Oh, yeah. There's a few different kids. There's a kid from there's a kid from Fern Creek. They're pretty good out of the 6th region. And then a kid down in Bowling Green that I play with, they'll both be down there. I'm not really sure. I haven't checked who's won every region, so I'm not sure who will be down there and who won't. But those are two off the top of my head.
So have you been texting back and forth?
Yeah, I told them the night that we played, they congratulated me, and I congratulated them because they played on Tuesday.
Good deal.
You had a chance to see Perry Central take on Knott Central in the 14th region championship. What are your thoughts on Perry Central, your next opponent?
Oh, they're a really good team. We went down there and watched them play Knott in the regional championship. They got some good bigs. They can shoot the ball. They're just overall good team.
All right, Wyatt, in the semifinal game against South Floyd, you pretty much put the team on your back, scored 30 in that game, pulled that one out right at the end, and then, of course, followed that up with the big game against Johnson Central, but with Evan and Cade helping you out. Which way do you like it? Do you like being the guy that pulls it out, or you like it where you got three or four guys?
It does not matter to me. As long as we win, it don't matter if I score 2 points or 30 points. In the South Floyd game, it's just kind of how they played. Our teammates were looking more for me. They gave me good looks. And just I was taking better shots that game. But it doesn't really matter to me now.
I kind of got on to him today at school. You know, if you wouldn't have slacked that fourth quarter, he had 12 points against South Floyd going into the fourth. He ends up with 30, so not a bad quarter.
Yeah. It's not a bad gig when you've got a guy like that that you can have him take over your team and lead you to a win. Heading to Rupp Arena, is this something you've dreamed about? I think most kids in Kentucky dream about playing in the state tournament.
Yeah, I didn't actually think about it much until I moved to Pikeville, and then I saw growing up, my fourth grade years when I really started dreaming about it is I saw them going to region. I was like, I heard that we hadn't won it since 1999. I just dreamed about me being the one and being a part of the team that really brought it back, and I wanted to win one ever since then.
A lot of dreams coming true with a regional championship. Has it sunk in yet now after a couple of days?
Sort of. it's a great feeling. Yeah, it has sunk in, but now we're more thinking about how we can get a win down the rough. We want to play more than one game down there.
You've got a favorable bracket. Perry Central, obviously, it's a game you can win.
Yep.
You look at the rest of the bracket, and there are many people saying if you guys play like you did against Johnson Central, play good basketball, you could end up playing on Saturday. Is this team prepared for that? What's the mood been like in practice?
We're fully confident in ourselves. We're not overlooking anybody by any means. We know how good the teams are down there. We know if we don't play good, we can be one and done. But I think everybody's confident. We're playing probably our best basketball we have all year. And we want to go down there, and we don't want to be just a token appearance. We want to be more than one and done.
Wyatt Battle, 15th Region Tournament MVP, Pikeville Junior, and heading to Rupp Arena next week. We want to wish you best of luck next week. Let's get a couple of wins, bring a trophy home.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
It's the Sports Guys. It's a championship edition celebrating the 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship, Pikeville and Perry Central, next Wednesday at Rupp Arena, and we'll be there to bring it back. We'll step out, take a break. You'll need meet another one of the Panthers when we return to Sports Guys Championship Edition.
Appalachian Antiques is rooting for the Pikeville Panthers in the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Let's go, Maroon and White!
McCoy Motorsports congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their victory in the 15th Region Tournament. Go Panthers! We're behind you all the way!
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at state from all of us at Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th Region Tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Welcome back in. Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville. It's home of the Sports Guys Championship Edition as we celebrate a Pikeville Panther 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship. The trophy's here. It's on the table as we broadcast from Buffalo Wild Wings. And, of course, we celebrate a championship with different teams from all throughout the region, many different times. This is one of the biggest championship edition crowds that we've had. It always draws a crowd, but there's a lot of maroon here enjoying the food. And this basket of wings, I'm pretty sure, is a prop.
That's going home with me. But there's more. You talk about the crowd in here. There's more that could even fit in here.
We've got an overflow. Yeah. And, of course, we've talked with the coach. We're previewing next week's Pikeville appearance in the state tournament. And now joined by Panther junior Evan Rhodes on this special edition. And Evan, congratulations on your 15th region championship.
Thank you.
You've got a big smile on your face. It's there usually, but it seems a little bigger tonight. Does the 15th region crown have something to do with that?
I'll tell you what, the smile has not went away since Monday night. So it's been there.
22 points in a championship game. It's a moment that will last a lifetime. What was it like Monday night?
Monday night was by far one of the best nights of my life. Coach has always told us that if we worked our butts off to win a regional championship, then it'd be a night that we never forget, and he's exactly right.
Yeah, he's been there, done that as a player. When he says things like that because he had been there as a player, does it mean a little more than some of those guys maybe that hadn't walked in those shoes?
It meant a lot to me because I went to the game and I knew he knew exactly what he was talking about, and it gave me that much more confidence to play my best game.
Got to ask you the question. You guys were down 18 points in the first half in the championship game. What was the mood like among your teammates? What was the mindset?
We knew that we couldn't really lose our focus. We knew we had to keep our focus and come out of the second half and just play just like we were tied or up a few points.
Come on now. Shoot straight with me. I'm going to shoot straight with you. There wasn't a little bit of doubt in your mind that, oh, crap, we're down 18, they're pretty good, and we're not playing very well.
Oh, I definitely had that thought in my mind. It was just that I just believe in my team and my coaches because I knew they've been in the situation before, and I knew we could do it.
Absolutely. You've shown that throughout the year, coming back against many different teams. But a championship win. Evan Rhodes, a big part of that, guys.
He really is, Evan. 22 points, career high.
Yeah, I'm guessing.
You know, it seems like and as the year has gone along, and you know me, I've been talking about how good a player you are since you were a freshman, and I've been telling everybody that would listen to me. But it seems that as the year has gone along, that you've gotten more comfortable out there as you've gotten more playing time. And now with your shot, you're at first, you know, you'd hesitate some, but now you just let it fly because you're comfortable with your shot as well.
Yeah.
That experience helping you out as far as the confidence goes?
Yes, that just having the chance to come out during big games like that, it when you do make good, like, big plays, it does boost your confidence a lot, and it just you stay in the rhythm. And the juniors in my class, we've been playing together since fourth grade, and it just made it that much easier for us to click and do what we needed to do for our team.
Evan, I have to say, even games Frosty didn't do, he was texting me saying, how many did Evan get? And usually you had a good night. I have to ask you, though, during the comeback, you did a lot of the driving and the layups, but what surprised me, you nailed two threes that were critical. No hesitation whatsoever. What was it that said, all right, I need to shoot it from here and I've got it?
Well, I knew that if I had the open shot, I needed to take it. But coming to that game, my focus was on winning that championship. And the crowd and stuff didn't come into effect until after I shot the ball, it seemed like. So it was amazing.
Played in front of a big crowd. Yeah. Semifinal night and championship night. I would imagine those are the biggest crowds you played in front of.
Oh, by far.
Next Wednesday at Rupp Arena, I've got a feeling the crowd will be a little bigger. Not a great deal different than the Expo Center. Well, a little different than the Expo Center. But playing in front of those crowds and the closeness of those crowds, do you think that helps prepare this team for a place like Rupp?
Yeah, definitely. We've always wanted to play in Rupp, and we knew how big of a change it was going to be from playing in the high school gym, and then be able to play in the Expo makes it a little bit more comfortable going into it, but it's still going to be a really big change.
You had a couple of nights to play in the Expo Center and adjust to the shooting lines and things like that, and there are many people that say, well, shooters have a tough time in the Expo Center. You didn't seem to have that tough of time. How big of adjustment is it from the gym, from the TW Oliver, then playing in the Expo? How much of an adjustment is it for a shooter?
Well, it's a really big difference when you're actually out on the court shooting the ball because just the atmosphere is so much different. But if you coach told us to stay focused and just to play our game, and that's exactly what we did.
Evan, I know you've been banged up in football and even in basketball with the ankle stuff. What's it feel like to go through a season pretty much injury-free?
It is absolutely 100% worth it.
Heading to Rupp Arena next week to face Perry County Central. You had a chance to see the Commodores in the 14th Region Championship. Your thoughts as you prepare for that team, what you saw at Breathitt County?
Well, I went to watch that game, and I knew that they were going to be really good, and that's exactly what I saw. Knott County played in a very good game. So either way, I believe in my team that, like, we're going to play our best game and hopefully come out on top.
You guys have a shot against them. And then Harlan County also in the same bracket, a team that you guys have played. And it was a very competitive game playing at their place. You have to like the draw if you look down the road, but, of course, one at a time.
Yeah. Evan, I know that your mom and dad are awful proud of you sitting right over there. And, you know, they love watching you play as I do. Mm. But the big question that they want to know, and I want to know too, how's the grades?
The grades?
Yeah.
They're up there.
Up there? Yeah. Really good student. And he works as hard off the court on his grades as he does in basketball and football. Really does.
I love students. Hearing about these good students, the guys that put student athlete first the way it should be. That leads me to another question. Evan, what's your favorite subject?
Favorite subject would have to be, I would say gym class, but math.
That's a given.
Yeah,
that's
math
a given.
Probably.
Oh, math.
A math guy. See, we've got a stinking genius on the panel. Jim's a math guy, too. Yep. So now we've got two stinking geniuses.
Just feed him in.
Yeah.
Evan, I got to ask you, you played in the football championship last year. I know Rupp Arena holds a lot more people than what was at Western, but do you think playing in a game like that gets you mentally prepared to play Wednesday?
I definitely think it is. I think it will help prepare us for that game. The environment during that state championship game was it was amazing. Even though I was just a sophomore, it was unbelievable.
Evan Rhodes, the Pikeville junior, and had a big night at the 15th region championship, a key part of this Panthers team success as we celebrate a regional championship with the Panthers. Evan, best of luck at Rupp Arena next week. Congratulations on a great season already.
Thank you.
Evan Rhodes, we'll step out. We'll take a break. We'll come back. We'll be joined by another one of the players. It's a Panther Championship edition of the Sports Guys, and we're back right after this, live from Buffalo Wild Wings.
El Azul Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Thacker Memorial congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the 15th Region Tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16. Way to go, Panthers!
Rodney Scott and the Pike County Sheriff's Department congratulate the Pikeville Panthers, 15th Region Tournament champs. Good luck at the Sweet 16 Tournament, Panther Pride. Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th Region Tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th region tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Welcome back in. It is the Sports Guys Championship Edition coming to you live from Buffalo Wild Wings, and the house is rocking tonight. A lot of maroon here at B-Dubs, not just in the room that we are in, but it's an overflow crowd. There is maroon throughout Buffalo Wild Wings, a great crowd on hand, and we expect that when the Sports Guys leave the studio and go out celebrating a championship of some sorts, we're used to these kind of crowds. Because it's a special time, a championship for Pikeville and the 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship, one that goes back 18 years. And Frosty, this is different than the 50s. Pikeville had a long run in the 50s, a much more competitive region now. And it's tougher for a small school to have this type of run to be able to knock off the biggest school in the region.
It really is. And when you look back at the 50s and you look at the scores of the finals, and you know, you had teams like Pikeville. Inez was a big team back there. So a lot of small schools back then, you didn't have the consolidations. And it was, I mean, and nothing to take anything away from, because they had some dynasties back then.
Sure.
And some great ball players. But, you know, bigger, faster, stronger athletes. And we've got one down here on our left that proves that, the faster, stronger, and bigger part. But, I think it's a lot tougher, you know, especially Johnson Central. You know, by far, they double everybody in enrollment. But to beat them in the finals just makes it even better.
Absolutely. And especially we keep going back to, they had an 18-point lead in the first half.
Right.
And I don't care who you are, what sport you're playing, when a team falls behind early in a championship game, there's a couple of directions they can go. And many times it's not the way the Panthers did it in rallying, cutting, chipping away at a lead before the half, and then exploding in the second half. One of the reasons that they did explode in the second half joins us now. Cade Byers, 11 of 11 from the field, 28 points on the night. Cade Byers, a Pikeville junior, joins us now. And Cade, wow, what a championship night performance. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Cade Byers, he's that guy, Frosty, we've talked about. Okay, he's been a solid player. He's done this, he's done that. But he didn't surprise his teammates, many of them not surprised by his breakout performance.
It didn't surprise me, but, Cade, I just got one question. 28 points, why have you been holding back all year?
I don't know. I just came out, and they drove. They got past their man. They drew my man, and then I got easy baskets.
Of course, we talked about your 28 points and 11-11 from shooting. I think you just missed, what, one free throw, Andrew?
One free throw. I was going to ask, what's up with that?
Yeah.
You know, if you're going to have a perfect night from the field, what's up with the free throw line?
But, you know, we hadn't even gotten to your block shots yet. I mean, you had two or three key blocks and did well on the boards. Was that kind of your role, or did you all talk about that before the game? If one of their guards, and they like to penetrate too, they can shoot the three. But if they were to go by, get by with their man, were you the kind of the eraser back there? You kind of keeping your eye on them?
Yeah, every game I come in, I just make sure to contest every shot that comes in near the rim. I started on Mason, but he was just hitting threes over top of me and Wyatt. So we switched to 2-3, and we contained him pretty good.
Yeah, Cade, I've got to ask you, you know, we talked about the 28 points. What gave you the confidence, and your teammates looked for you, to know against what was supposed to be the best team in the region that you could put on a performance like that?
I just knew that if I got the ball, I was just going to take it to the hole as hard as I could, because I knew that I could finish around the rim with them. They don't have anyone that's very big or can jump very high, so I just knew I could out-jump all of them.
28 points, a career high, Kate.
Yes, it is.
Not even in Pee Wee, growing up, junior high, you never had 28?
I don't think so.
See, I told you, he's been holding back.
I know.
He's waiting
for
this moment. And, Cade, just so you know, Cade's a baseball guy, too.
Right.
He's a heck of a baseball player. You might not believe this. This guy right here, pretty good baseball player.
Yes,
Powell went on to play college baseball at Elon University.
Yeah, it's a long time ago.
You can ask any baseball question. You just direct it to him.
Yeah, it's when they didn't wear helmets, Cade. So it's a long time ago.
He's joking.
There's a reason for that. Cade Byers, you're heading to Rupp Arena. Is that something you've dreamed about growing up as an athlete?
Yeah, I haven't thought about it in a couple of years because I didn't ever think I was going to play basketball again. But I guess I came out this year. I helped my team get some victories, and we're going to Rupp Arena, so it's pretty exciting.
What's it been like at school, in the community, on your smartphone since the championship on Monday night? I would imagine your phone's blown up, and at school and in the community, things have been a little different.
Yeah, I've just had a lot of people patting me on the back, telling me that I did really good and that I helped my team win in a very big role in the win.
At what point in the game, Cade, and I know, of course, you finished with 28, led Pavel scoring, but at what point in the game did you think to yourself, hey, I'm having a pretty good game? Or did you know how many points you had at halftime? Or at what point did you – I mean, it had to start sinking in, hey, I'm having a pretty good game tonight.
Once I got the and-one layup on the fast break, I noticed then. I just looked up at the scoreboard, and I was like, man, I'm having a really good game.
I like it. I've got to tell you, Cade, my favorite play was not a scoring play. is when you blocked Blair's shot and it ended up landing on him out of bounds.
On his head.
Got the ball back. Yeah, nice play.
Thank you.
Cade Byers, a huge night in the 15th region championship, on his way to Rupp Arena with the Pikeville Panthers as we celebrate a 15th region championship. It's a special edition of the Sports Guys. And Cade, we want to wish you the best of luck next
Thank
week
you.
In Rupp Arena and in your career as it continues. What a great job in the regional championship, and it's something that will be remembered for a long time.
Thank you.
Thanks for being with us tonight.
Thank you.
It is the Sports Guys. It is a special edition live from Buffalo Wild Wings. You still have time to join us. Wear your maroon, wear your Pikeville gear, and there are food discounts tonight as well. Come on down, have dinner, have a late snack, and join the Pikeville faithful. The players are here. The coaches are here celebrating that 15th region championship. We'll get a break. We'll come back. You'll meet another one of the Panthers next when the Sports Guys return after this.
More new cars, more new trucks, more certified vehicles. That's the Hutch Chevrolet Advantage. At Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC, you can take advantage of over 300 vehicles in stock, pre-owned cars and trucks, starting at under $10,000. On Hutch Certified Pre-Owns, you receive an exclusive 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance plan, 2 manufactured-backed warranties, and 24/7 roadside assistance. What are you waiting for? Start shopping now at HutchAutoGroup.com and come see us at Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC in Paintsville.
Rodney Scott and the Pike County Sheriff's Department congratulate the Pikeville Panthers 15th Region Tournament champs. Good luck at the Sweet 16 Tournament, Panther Pride.
El Azul Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th region tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th region tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at state from all of us at Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry.
Welcome back to Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville. It's a championship edition of the Sports Guys as we take the show on the road, celebrating championships with many teams, many years. We've been able to celebrate championships, and the 15th Region Boys Basketball Region Champion Trophy is in the house here at Buffalo Wild Wings tonight because the Panthers defeated Johnson Central Monday night in the 15th Region Championship. Frosty Davis, what an atmosphere. Something we haven't talked about is the atmosphere at the Expo Center for the 15th Region Tournament, is in particular the semifinals yeah. and championship night.
Well, and, you know, we've talked about it earlier. The two semifinal games, of course, Lawrence and Johnson Central, Pikeville and South Florida, and then your championship game. That's three of the best basketball tournament games that yes. I have seen. And I couldn't tell you when. I mean, they, you know, Johnson Central had to come down from 12 to beat Lawrence. Pikeville, South Florida, they were nip and tuck the whole way. Pikeville kind of pulled away there 2-3 minutes left in the game. And then, you know, who could ask for a better championship game coming down from 18 points to win the game?
Absolutely. And Panthers sophomore Connor Roberts joins us now on this special edition of the Sports Guys. And Connor, great job in the 15th region tournament. Congratulations on a regional championship. What's it feel like?
It feels amazing. I mean, we dreamed of this our whole lives, basically. Just wanted to go play at Rupp Arena, and then finally it came true.
Very good. Of course, Johnson Central, I've asked everybody that's been here, your team's down 18 points in the first half. What's going through your mind?
Well, our coaches told us they wouldn't be able to hit the threes like they did the whole game. And second half, we kind of came out. And at the beginning of the game, we didn't really get much time to practice with our press. And then at the end of the game, we kind of started to figure it out and kind of broke it and got layups.
Yeah. Connor, you, Evan, and Kyle are the perfect fit for this kind of system. The pressing, the back taps, the turnovers. Do you guys have any kind of competition amongst you to see who gets the most steals or anything like that?
During practice, it's really competitive. We always go against each other one-on-one, full court, and stuff like that. We switch up, and we kind of take it like a friendly competition during the games, I would say.
Make each other better.
Yeah.
Guys, yeah, of course, I know these guys pretty well, but you've heard of the hardest working man in show business.
Right.
This guy right here, the hardest working man in basketball. Many times, I get to school every morning a little bit before 7, and even during football season, when it wasn't even basketball season, there were times that I saw his car down there already and him in the gym working. Connor, where do you get your drive and your work ethic from? And I mean it in all sincerity. You work harder than anybody on the team.
I appreciate it. I would say as a kid, I grew up watching Elijah play, and then whenever I was growing up, he would have camps and stuff, and I would go to that, and I went to a few personal workouts with him and go work out with him, and I would probably say that's where I got my drive to work hard and stuff, along with everybody else telling me you got to work for what you want in life, and apparently it's paid off.
It is. And, you know, after Monday night, the team took Tuesday and Wednesday off. They didn't practice. I walked got out of my office at 4, and I was leaving. I walked through the gym. Guess who's the only one in the gym?
I believe Roberts. It.
The gym rat.
That's
the
right.
Gym rat. Hey, how much of that has to do with being a coach's kid? Because we hear that coaches' kids, they're always the first one in the gym, the last one out of the gym. You grow up that way. And just be always being around it. Did that develop a love, or was that something that was expected?
Yeah, I had some coaches as a young kid, too, that kind of developed my love for basketball. And my dad would always put a lot of pressure on me, and he pushed me to the extreme. And he'd always tell me he would put pressure on me, so whenever I get older, I don't feel as much pressure.
Where does the pressure come from now, Dad, or does that come from within?
A little bit of both. If I know if I go home and I played a bad game, I'm going to hear it.
Yeah.
But if I play a good game, I'm going to hear it.
I was going to say you didn't hear it often.
And that makes a difference.
You get some big threes in this tournament, then, and one that sticks out in my mind is the and one. Not too many times that you get fouled on a three-point shot and make it and get to go to the free throw line. Tell us about that play. That was a huge play in that ball game too.
Yeah, I'd always tell these guys on our team about how I'd never got an and-one three. I talked about it all the time, and I finally get one, go to the free throw line. I missed that free throw.
I wasn't going to bring that up. See, you're not supposed to bring that up.
That was
a great play, though. That was a big momentum changer in that ball game.
Yeah.
Connor, I've got to ask the question. You talked about watching your head coach, Elijah Justice, as a player and his run to a state championship with Shelby Valley. You're similar type players. When you look at, you know, the defensive guys, the guys that can hit the three, that will get the steals, similar in stature as well. Seeing him play and now playing for him, how important is that to a guard that plays the type of defense that you do?
I really look up to him, and I've got a bunch of his films and stuff from him this offseason and watched them to try to learn the way they play and everything. And him and the rest of the coaches have kind of taught us how to win. I mean, they've won at every level, and they're just kind of spreading it down to us and letting us see what it feels like to win and everything.
You know, Connor, I got to ask you, the All-A Classic at the Expo did not go the way Pikeville wanted it to. Getting to play there again in the regional tournament, how much was that a motivating factor to come out and play different?
Well, I missed a few free throws at the end of that East Ridge All-A game, and I had a lot of people text me and told me just to keep my faith strong and everything, that God has a purpose. And then we came out, and I started working my free throws more, and it kind of – that game really bothered me for a while, and I just kept working on my free throws, and I came in and made a few more.
Totally different, absolutely.
Connor Roberts, Panthers sophomore guard, our guest on this special edition of the Sports Guys. We celebrate a championship as the Panthers will take on Perry County Central next Wednesday at Rupp Arena. Connor, you had a chance along with your teammates to see Perry Central. What are your thoughts on the Commodores?
I thought that their inside game was extremely well. So, but I think we can pressure their guards and run the floor, get up and down the floor, and I think we can beat them.
Very good.
And what's your feeling about going down and playing in Rupp Arena?
It's going to be an exciting game.
Have you been there for the state tournament before?
Yeah, I went and watched Coach play his last 2 years that they were down there, and then the year after that I was actually the water boy whenever Coach Newsom coached the year after Brewer left, and we got a tour of the Kentucky locker room and everything, and I was kind of like backstage and everything. I got to see everything, and then now that I actually get to go down there and play, it's a crazy feeling.
Yeah. It's a great atmosphere, and it's something that basketball players in Kentucky dream of their entire lives. You've got a dream that will come true next Wednesday. And, Connor, we want to wish you the best of luck next week. Let's go get a win.
All right. We'll try.
Connor Roberts, sophomore guard with the Pikeville Panthers, your 2017 15th Region Boys Basketball Champions. These guys feel as if they're pretty confident. Don't you get that feeling?
And they're well-spoken. That's kind of unusual for high schoolers. You know, we've done a lot of these, and every player we've had up here so far could just jump on there and do a game with us. I mean, they're great speakers, and Connor Roberts as well.
Yeah. Pikeville, of course, takes on Perry Central next week at Rupp Arena. We'll be there. We'll have it on the air for you back here. But I got a feeling there'll be a huge contingent of Panther faithful there. Nearly 20 years between appearances, you'll have Panthers from all across the Commonwealth at Rupp Arena next week, not just here locally making the trip, and of course we'll be there as well. It's a Sports Guys Championship edition, and we'll return live from Buffalo Wild Wings. More players on the air when we come back after this.
More new cars, more new trucks, more certified vehicles. That's the Hutch Chevrolet Advantage. At Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC, you can take advantage of over 300 vehicles in stock, pre-owned cars and trucks, starting at under $10,000. On Hutch Certified Pre-Owns, you receive an exclusive 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance plan, 2 manufactured-backed warranties, and 24/7 roadside assistance. What are you waiting for? Start shopping now at HutchAutoGroup.com and come see us at Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC in Paintsville.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th region tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th region tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Elizalde Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Thacker Memorial congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the 15th Region Tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16. Way to go, Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Welcome back to Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville. It's a Sports Guys Championship edition celebrating the Pikeville Panthers' 15th region championship as the Panthers prepare to take on Perry County Central next week at Rupp Arena. Frosty Davis, you've got someone special.
Got a special guest right here. Before we get to Mr. Kyle Watkins down here, member of the 15th region championship team, I just want everybody in Pikeville to know this is the next big thing right here. In basketball, I'll let her tell you your name. Tell her your name.
Catherine Walters.
Catherine Walters, also known as Cat, I believe. I've heard about you. quite a girls basketball player. She's got her Pikeville Panthers girls basketball shirt on. She's already sporting the look. Kat, I've got to ask you, do you have plans to play in the Sweet 16 later on in your basketball career?
Yeah.
See, I had a feeling that that was coming. So you saw these guys win a regional championship and win a trophy, and that's in your future as well. So you're going to be a big scorer and be a champion someday.
Yeah. Frosty.
Her favorite sports guy is Frosty. Very good. Catherine Walters right there, just one of the Panther fans in the house here at Buffalo Wild Wings. And, Jim, there's a lot of maroon here.
There's a lot of maroon, not only in this room, but in the room out there as well.
You may be able to see that on camera. The room that we are in, it's stacked full of maroon, but an overflow crowd celebrating a Panther championship and an excited community. And we talked about it after this championship. This is the third in our lifetime, and the Panthers have won a few, but you've got to go back a few years past that when Pikeville won in 99 and then back in 74 when the Panthers went on to the Sweet 16 as well. But heading to the Sweet 16 next week in Rupp Arena, taking on Perry County Central, and joined by another Panther player now, Kyle Watkins, a sophomore, joins us. Kyle, congratulations on your 15th region championship.
Thank you. I really appreciate it.
Starting this season, starting this tournament, did you have dreams that this Pikeville team could win a 15th region crown?
Well, we knew that this summer that we put hard work in, and then the off season, constantly with the 6 a.m. morning workouts and after school workouts and going over film. Everybody on the team knew their role, and we went into this tournament knowing that we had just as good of a shot as anybody in the thing to win it. And we came out with the mindset that they were going to win it no matter who in the community was doubting us. We were going to make Pikeville proud and bring another regional title back to the school.
Shoot straight with us. When you were down 18 points in the first half, were you doubting yourself then?
Well, I had some worry, but I knew that what we have been over, and we've practiced with these guys all year, and I know that they had fight in them. And I know that when we got down that we were just going to keep fighting. We weren't going to give up and let our community down and then give a bad representation of our school. So we just kept fighting until the end, and then we had a good outcome. Now we're region champs.
Kyle, as the point guard at Johnson Central, they're known for a really good full-court press. And, you know, early in the game, and we had some turnovers. And whether you're the one committing the turnovers or not, everybody looks to the point guard to kind of, settle down. But, they are good defensively. But you guys seem like when you got down 18 and we started pressing, then you started attacking that press more offensively, and it worked for you.
Yeah, when we got down 18, we knew that we had to change something up. We knew that we had to take it. We couldn't sit back because we were down. And if you sit back against Johnson Central, they're just going to keep piling up. So we knew that we had to attack and take every advantage that was possible, and that's what we did.
You know, as starting point guard this year, new system and a lot expected out of you, did you put a lot of pressure on yourself, or did it come easy for you as you went along?
Well, it was sort of easy. I've been a point guard my whole life, and it made it a whole lot easier knowing that I had these coaches backing me up. And with the experience, especially of Coach Justice, of what he's been through and playing at Louisville and knowing how to run it, and he gave me a lot of support, and it really helped me out a lot through the years, and especially Coach Boober too. Just he said you got to be like a sponge out there. You just got to absorb everything that we tell you and then take it. He said you're the man out there running the show, and that's what I tried to do whenever I was out there on the court.
Does that add any pressure playing for a guy like Elisha Justice, who was such an amazing point guard? Wins Mr. Basketball, goes on, plays at Louisville, finishes his career at UPike, and I think still holds the state record for steals. He was one of the premier point guards to ever play in Eastern Kentucky. Does that add pressure to you being his point guard?
Well, it does a little bit, because you know that people have, especially people outside the community, have expectations on you. But he gives us a lot of support, and he doesn't come on as cocky as himself. And he really helps us out, and he wants to push us to be better than he was. So it's not as bad as what people might think it might be.
those are some pretty big expectations to be better than he was. He was at Andy, proving to be a great coach early in his career as well. Does it help you knowing that he's been there, he's done that, he won a championship taking a team to Rupp Arena? How has that helped you guys in just a couple, 3 days preparing to play in Rupp? How does that transfer to you guys, his time and his experience there?
Well, nobody on the team has any doubt that we're getting coached the wrong way or something's not right. Everybody is buying into the system, and we're going to go by whatever he wants to go by, and then that's what we're going to do when we go down there Wednesday. And we're going to try to bring back a state championship back to Pikeville as best we can.
Very good.
You know, one thing I've noticed, we've talked about you running the show and the passing, but you've developed into a good three-point shooter. How much pride and effort do you put into that?
Well, you know, with everybody, a lot of teams focusing on Wyatt Battle, then he really opens up a lot of stuff for us guards. So we have to be prepared when he drives in, ready to shoot the ball. Because if we're not, then it's a problem. So we really practice every day to get as many shots up as we can. And going into a game, that makes us a lot more confident know that we're going to be able to knock down a shot when he gives us an open look.
Kyle, you hit some big, big threes throughout the regional tournament, and you mentioned that you've always played point guard. And, of course, a lot of people look at the point guard kind of running the team, the quarterback, you know, having a lot of assists. But have you always been a good shooter from three-point land, or is this something that you just worked on and gotten better at over the years?
Well, ever since I was little, I've always had a good three-point shot. So this year especially, it's got better, but I've always been pretty good from the three-point.
And at halftime, what did you guys talk about when you went in the locker room at halftime? And you had a little bit of momentum then.
Well, when we went in, the coaches pretty much told us that we were playing bad and we were still just down 8 points. So we knew that if we turned it up, then we was going to come out victorious. And we went out and gave it everything that we had left in us and left it all out on the floor, and we came out.
At what point Monday night did you realize that you guys were going to win this game? At what point? Was it the final horn? Was it before that?
Well, I knew whenever, right before the final horn, that whenever we had the momentum, they were pressing us, and I could see it in those seniors' eyes that they were getting down on themselves from Johnson Central.
Yeah.
And we were just driving, and they were trying to trap us in the press, and we were breaking it and scoring and getting and ones, making our free throws. And I knew when they went down and they were throwing up bad shots that it was our game. It was our game to take.
Your game to take indeed. And Pikeville gets the win 95-84 over Johnson Central, and you now are 15th region champions. Has it sunk in, Kyle, that there are very few people that can call themselves regional champions, that they have lifetime memories of going to Rupp Arena? Has it sunk in yet that there are those people that will look back at their high school days and remember a team 18 years ago that went to the state tournament, or a team, 43 years ago, yeah, that went to a state tournament, and now you're one of those teams? Has it sunk in?
Well, not really. The hype's kind of still up there, but we still have to humble ourselves, and we got to get ready and prepare for Perry. But you know, this is an awesome experience, and just thinking back of all the teams that's not been able to call themselves regional champs,
indeed,
and be able to play at Rupp, and how great they were, and us winning and getting to go play there, it's phenomenal. It's phenomenal. It really is.
Enjoy the ride.
Yeah.
Enjoy the ride.
We're going to take it every step that we can, every step that we can.
Kyle Watkins, Panthers sophomore, and we celebrate a 15th region championship. It's a special edition of the Sports Guys as Pikeville celebrates the 15th region boys basketball championship on their way to Rupp Arena. And, of course, we'll be there next week to bring the broadcast to you. Kyle Watkins, we want to wish you the best of luck next week.
Thank you.
We'll step out. We'll be rejoined. You'll meet another one of the Panther players when the Sports Guys return. After this, we are live from Buffalo Wild Wings.
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at State from all of us at Shirtless Dry Cleaning and Laundry.
McCoy Motorsports congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their victory in the 15th Region Tournament. Go Panthers! We're behind you all the way.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
McCoy Motorsports congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their victory in the 15th Region Tournament. Go Panthers! We're behind you all the way.
Thacker Memorial congratulates the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the 15th Region Tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16. Way to go, Panthers!
Hello everybody, I'm Sean Allen, inviting you to join me Saturday and Sunday nights at 6-4 this week. Look, we know you're busy all week long. This week is an opportunity to get caught up on everything that happened that matters to you, and we'll make sure you're prepared for the week ahead. From local sports to news, weather, and what's going on in your hometown, EKB TV's This Week is your weekend fix to stay informed, so check local cable listings, set your DVR to check out This Week, right here on EKB TV.
Welcome back to Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville. I can't believe that we've been here for an hour and a half now and nobody has even checked these wings to see how hot they are, to see how meaty they are. And we've left those, any other edition of the sports guys, they would have been torn into and right. We would have torn those things apart.
Right.
But they've sat there for an hour and a half. Nobody's touched those.
I'm going to make them disappear after the show. They're going home with me.
It is a
me and Chris is going to split them.
It's a special edition of the Sports Guys coming to you live from Buffalo Wild Wings. Frosty Davis, Jim Williamson, I'm Andrew Joyce. The Sports Guys in the house. The coaches in the house. A lot of Panther fans in the house as well. Celebrating a 15th region championship as Pikeville heads to the Sweet 16. Next Wednesday in Rupp Arena, and of course we'll be there. Frosty, we've got a special guest on hand who had some significant plays in the 15th Region Championship.
Yeah, it's Kristen Builder, and Kristen, you came a long way this year, buddy. Of course, plays football too as well.
Yes.
Really, really good athlete. And Kristen, first off, let's see, what camera do we have? Which camera are we on? I want you to look over here to the camera and give me just a little bit, one time. Come on.
Yeah, we were told that he's the dancer
the
team.
He is.
And we were told that we could get something full on, not just a little chair wiggle. I can do that. I got that. But we thought that we could get a little more. Christian, do you have it in you?
I might, you know.
All right. We've got a camera set right here for you. If you need to take the headset off, clear the chair. We've got a little room. We want you to bring us your best 15th Region Championship dance move.
So, like, what I did in the huddle?
Sure.
Yeah,
let's see it right here, right now, in front of everybody at B-Dubs.
Let's go.
There it is right there. I got to say, that was pretty impressive.
Hey, I mean, he can dance now. I'd like to see him with some music, see what he can do.
I know.
I could take him to some shows and win some money, I'm pretty sure. Hey,
ladies and gentlemen, it is not the Sports Guys Championship Edition. It is the Sports Guys Dancing with the Panthers Edition.
Wow, there you go.
Christian Billiter, sophomore with the 15th Region Champion Pikeville Panthers, joins us now. And first of all, congratulations on a 15th Region Championship. What's it feel like?
You know, it just feels amazing, you know. It's just ever since I was little, I've always had the dream of winning a championship, you know, going long ways and just winning big things. So it just feels amazing.
You'll get a chance to do that dance in Rupp Arena. What's that like?
It's crazy, you know. Just how, like, you grow up looking at these Wildcat stars, you know, playing on that court, and just to see that I'll be there and, like, getting a chance to play on that court just means the world. It's just shocking, you know, just crazy.
Christian, you've seemed like you've gotten more comfortable as the season's gone along, and you're a great three-point shooter, great athlete. And I can remember, and I can't remember what game it was, but I was talking to your mom after the game, and I don't think it was one of your better nights, and she was a little bit worried. I'm like, yeah, be patient. I said, the more playing time he gets, the more comfortable that he'll be and the better that you'll play. When did you start getting comfortable this year coming off the bench and giving your team some big minutes? When did you really feel comfortable out there?
It's probably like that tournament down there in Florida. You know, we were doing so good against Cambridge, and so they're like, Christian, we're going to need you out there. You know, just do what you do best. And so I went out there. I hit three big threes, you know, kind of brought us back in the game. But, you know, I just go out there, try to help my team win. That's all I want to do.
You know, Christian, I'm going to say you excel as a role player, and I don't mean that bad. The interesting thing with you is your role could be inside one night, could be outside the next night, just like in a regional championship game when Byers fouled out. You hit the boards hard, but you also hit a big three.
And you were also guarding Mason Blair.
Yeah, and also guarding Blair. So how much pride do you take in having a game to where if they need you outside, you can do that. If they need you hitting the boards, you can do that.
I take major pride in that. You know, I just want to do the best at everything I do. I just want to help my team win. You know, that's what I practice for, is just to get my team better and just help us do better in the end. So,
and I think one of the plays that turned that game around against Johnson Central is your tip in. Take us through that. And you know, I saw you crash the boards hard, but what were you thinking?
Well, I just saw that when it left the hand, I just knew it wasn't going to be, you know, wasn't going to go in. And I saw a lane just right there, so I just went after it and grabbed it, put it in.
Christian Billiter, a Panthers sophomore, joins us. And, Christian, you had a chance to see Perry Central, your next opponent. You guys saw them at Breathitt County. What were your thoughts after watching the Commodores?
You know, they're a great team. They're well coached. You know, they got good players inside and out. And it's going to be a good game, so just be ready for it.
Be honest with me. You know, they've all come back with the canned answer. You know, they're a good team. It's going to be a tough game. We're going to have to play hard. I get that. But deep down, when you saw Perry Central play, did you walk out there and say, you know, we can beat those guys?
Of course. Every team, I know we can beat any team. We're just that good of a team. You know, we're well coached by Coach Justice and Coach Beaver. I believe that we are the best team in the state. That no one can touch us when we're at our best.
Very good. I like it. And that's an honest answer, because I think teams that have a certain amount of confidence, that are playing well, they can compete with anyone. And, you know, deep down, you walk out, you know, if you see a team play that's that much better than you, you may walk out and deep down you say, well, you know, we're going to have a tough time. But I think your confidence is real. Mm-hmm. And I think we've heard that from most of the players here tonight that have seen Perry Central play. We want to wish you guys the best of luck.
Thank you.
Commodores, it will be a tough task. Rupp Arena, a different kind of place to play. But we have a lot of confidence in this 15th region championship team as well.
Thank you.
Christian Billiter, Panthers sophomore, our guest, as it's a special edition of the Sports Guys, a 15th region championship edition. We'd like to remind you, coming up tomorrow night, the University of Pikeville Bears, men and women, on their way to the national tournaments next week in Montana and in Kansas City. They'll be right here at Buffalo Wild Wings at 6:30 tomorrow night. So back-to-back nights of wings, guys.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Can't beat that.
I can handle that.
We'll step out. We'll come back. We'll have more guests on the way celebrating a 15th region championship from Buffalo Wild Wings with the Pikeville Panthers. It is the Sports Guys. We're back after this.
More new cars, more new trucks, more certified vehicles. That's the Hutch Chevrolet Advantage. At Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC, you can take advantage of over 300 vehicles in stock, pre-owned cars and trucks, starting at under $10,000. On Hutch Certified Pre-Owns, you receive an exclusive 2-year, 24,000-mile maintenance plan, 2 manufactured-backed warranties, and 24/7 roadside assistance. What are you waiting for? Start shopping now at HutchAutoGroup.com and come see us at Hutch Chevrolet Buick GMC in Paintsville.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th region tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Elizalde Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th region champions. Go Panthers!
Rodney Scott and the Pike County Sheriff's Department congratulate the Pikeville Panthers, 15th region tournament champs. Good luck at the Sweet 16 tournament, Panther Pride.
Hensley Real Estate Services is rallying behind the Pikeville Panthers and cheering the team to victory as they celebrate their 15th region tournament win and progress to the Sweet 16. Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th region tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Welcome back to Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville. It's a championship edition of the Sports Guys celebrating the Pikeville Panthers 15th Region Boys Basketball Championship. And the trophy sits here at the table. But, Frosty, this is only the third time in our lifetime, Jim,
yeah,
yours as well, that Pikeville has claimed a regional championship. And I got to tell you, some of the players, some of the fans have said it's sunk in. I'm not sure it has for me because it doesn't come around that often. For any school, when you have a team that wins back-to-back or three times, I think sometimes taken for granted that these are special occasions. That's why we're here tonight.
And you know, I don't think it's really going to fully set in until, you know, we go down the state tournament and do some damage down there, hopefully. And then when you come back and it's all over with, and then you start reflecting on it, I think that's really when it's going to set in, even with the players.
Yeah, we've got a guy that joins us now that has been there. And he's done some damage
once or
twice at the state tournament. He's got one of those big rings and, of course, celebrated a state championship on the floor at Rupp Arena. Athletic director at Pikeville High School, Jason Boer. Coach, I've got to call you coach because you and I rode that ride together a few years back. You've been there, done that. What's it like for you now? You've been there as a coach and player. Now as an administrator, how does it feel? Is it different?
Well, it's just every time you go to the Sweet 16 and win a regional championship, it's always a special time, and it's exciting. We're just so proud of our guys, obviously, but it's one thing we told the school on Monday before we went to the regional championship that night is that we're not just going to have to win it for the team, but like you said, it doesn't happen very often at Pikeville, but we're trying to do it for the whole community of Pikeville, and because we want them to experience that, just the ride all the way to Rupp Arena. And we're just so glad now that everybody gets to go. And you know, on the administration side of it, you know, we're just a little small school in Eastern Kentucky, and we're going to Rupp Arena for the first time in, you know, since 1999. So we put out T-shirt sales for 15th Region T-shirts, for instance, yesterday morning. Those were due this afternoon. Uh-huh. And we sold 1,100 T-shirts, regional championship T-shirts. We've got a lot of community support behind this team. And hopefully we'll have a big showing down at Rupp Arena. And these guys know. We've looked at the brackets, and I'm sure a lot of people have. And sometimes you get lucky in a draw. Sometimes you don't. And, you know, we feel like our draw is probably as good as we could get. Now, Perry Central is very good, obviously.
Sure.
But we're excited about our draw. And right now we're trying to get in the Final Four, and then you never know what can happen.
Right. You've been there as a coach, and you know exactly what that's like. You prepare. You've got 16 regional champions. Everybody can play when you get to Rupp Arena. You've got to show up. You've got to play, and you've got to get past the first moments of that game. Bright lights, big crowd, playing on the stage of the Bluegrass. You've got a guy who played for you, who played under the bright lights, big crowds, on the biggest stage in the Commonwealth. That's got to make you extremely proud to know that you've got one of your guys who went on to a great career, won a state championship, now coaching your team. Talk about that feeling of having one of your players go to that same that same pinnacle of high school coaching, and that's making a trip to the Sweet 16.
Well, one thing I told him is that there's a lot of great coaches that coach a long, long time in Kentucky high school basketball that never make it to the state tournament.
Sure.
And for him to do it his first year at Pikeville, he's been, you know, a head coach a couple years there at June Buchanan. But for me to sit back and watch a guy that I've seen grow up, I say
right.
a guy because he was a little boy when he started at Dorton and growing up through the Shelby Valley program with me, and just to watch him, all the accomplishments individually as a player he accomplished, and then now to do it as a coach, of course, I couldn't be more proud. He's like a son to me, but he does a tremendous job, and, of course, he always has. And one thing he's always hung his hat on, even as a player when he was 10, 12 years old, is he's going to outwork everybody. And that work ethic is carried over from his from being a player into him being a coach now. And he just tries to outwork everybody. And like I said, he's like a son, and I couldn't be more proud of him. And what a way to start your career at Pikeville.
Jason, we were talking to Coach Justice a while ago, and, you know, Andrew had mentioned that, you know, you were a player down there and when you were the head coach, and now that he was you're his assistant coach, and he told us that you made a better assistant coach than you did head coach.
Well, then, you know what I told
then,
him.
And then, of course, hold on. Then, of course, you got that old football coach that says, "Why, there ain't nothing to that. Any monkey can coach basketball."
Yeah.
I took two teams down there to the state tournament. But, you know, you've been down there with two different teams. People forget that you took Coach Holmes down there as well. Eliza's been down there as a player. How important is that experience of one going through it as a coach that you can help him, and then Elijah going through it as a player, that he can help his players, the routine that you have to have when you go down there, you know, when to get them off the feet, how much rest. How important is it to have that experience?
Well, if we back up to the regional tournament, I think that experience was very vital because we were able to take them through the whole regional tournament, those three games, and really talk to them about how to get to Rupp Arena. So I think that experience helped in the regional tournament. But then, of course, when you go to the Sweet 16 like you're talking about, we had our first practice back today from after we won the regional championship. So the first thing we talked about, we circled them up and we said, now, here's the next thing you've got to do. You know, you've got a week before we play. There's going to be a lot of hoopla, a lot of media requirements. There's going to be a lot of pep rallies and so forth. You've got to be able to balance what's business and what's the hoopla. And, like, tonight, you're coming here and having fun. But when we went to practice today, we lace them up, and when practice starts, we're back to our goal. And, you know, one thing we shared with the team is that a lot of teams over the years, this is their token appearance because their season's
right.
already made because they won a regional championship. So they're just going up there to have a token appearance at Rupp Arena, play their one game, and go home. But we talked about the bracket. We talked about the experience of what it's like when you get beat out the first round as opposed to when you get on a little roll and you win a game or two or three or four. How much funner and more exciting that is, not only for the team but for the school and the community. So hopefully we can use that experience and tell them really forecast of what's coming up in the next few days and what's going to happen once we get up there. Like the first day we go up on Tuesday, we'll practice at Transy and on a college floor, nice facility there. So hopefully, like I said, we can use all that experience from, you know, in the past of making it to Rupp Arena, you know, a few times. In our advantage to that. And, of course, Greg Newsom, he's the other assistant coach. He's been a lot of times as well.
To the team as well.
You know, that experience can't hurt, and hopefully we can use that to our advantage and, you know, get past that first round. That's the hardest thing is get that first win
yeah.
under your belt.
Yeah.
And that's what when I was at Shelby Valley, same thing. That once we got that first win, it was Elijah's junior year, and, you know, then you can start getting that momentum going. That next year we came back, so – hopefully it don't take us another year to get there and we can get the momentum going right off the bat this time.
You walked out of Rupp Arena in 2010 as state champions. Elijah was, of course, a player of yours. Did you ever dream that you would be an administrator, he would be a coach someday, taking another team back to Rupp Arena?
Well, not really, because to be honest with you, I thought he was going to go on to Louisville and with Rick Pitino and probably just ride the wave coaching and go into college. But I often kidded him back when he was going into college, saying he may one day want to get into coaching. I said, well, you can come back and I can hire you as your assistant. I'll never forget that. He looked me in the eye and said, no, you can be my assistant. And I never in a million years thought that I would ever, you know, be back as his athletic director, assistant coach with him. And here we are together, and to sit back on the sidelines and watch him win a regional championship as a head coach was really just a dream come true for him and me as well. So No-hits. He that was a true story, and I'll never forget him telling me that. No, he can be my assistant.
Yeah, and it's worked out. He made that point early on tonight as well, that it took you a few more years to get to the Sweet 16, and he's done it in just, what, 3 years.
Right.
He's already there. So he was pointing that out as well. Yeah. Let's hope he finds as much success at the Sweet 16 as you did as well. Coach Jason Boer, thanks for being with us, and congratulations. What a great atmosphere at Pikeville right now. State championships in football, national championships in cheerleading. All the sports seem to have caught fire, and it's a great time to be a Panther with this regional championship. I know you're proud of the entire program.
Well, one thing I say at Pikeville is winning is contagious. And once somebody gets on a roll, like the football, like you said, then the dance team, you know, wins state championship. Then the cheerleading's got back-to-back national champs, and now we've won a regional championship in basketball. So winning is contagious, and it's so much you know, positive excitement at Pikeville right now, especially with all the sports programs, and we're just it's exciting time to be a Pikeville Panther.
No doubt about it. Athletic director at Pikeville High School, Jason Boer, our guest. We'll step out. It's a Sports Guys Championship Edition, celebrating the 2017 Pikeville Panthers 15th Region Championship. We'll be back. More Sports Guys live from Buffalo Wild Wings right after this.
Epic Escape Game Pikeville would like to congratulate PHS on their win in the 15th Region Tournament and their advancement to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers from Bank 253 Restaurant and Nightlife. Bank 253 celebrates the Panthers' recent victory in the 15th Region Tournament and wishes them luck in the Sweet 16.
Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry would like to congratulate the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. Best of luck at state from all of us at Shirtlift's Dry Cleaning and Laundry.
Congratulations to Coach Elijah Justice and the Pikeville Panthers on their 15th Region Tournament win. Velocity Market wishes you the best of luck at Rupp Arena. Go Panthers!
Elizul Grande Mexican Restaurant supports the Pikeville Panthers as they advance to the 100th Boys Sweet 16 Tournament at Rupp Arena. Congrats to the 15th Region Champions. Go Panthers!
Congratulations to the Pikeville Panthers on their win in the Boys 15th Regional Tournament. From everyone at Craig Dameron Furniture, best of luck in the tournament.
Welcome back to Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville as we are winding down a championship edition of the Sports Guys. Of course, Pikeville celebrating a 15th region championship, and the Panthers make their first trip to the Sweet 16 since 1999, 18 years since their last visit, and then you have to look forward to 43 years since their visit in 1974. We've talked about that tonight. Jim Williamson with us tonight, Frosty Davis, Jamie Johnson's in the house, and the entire crew from EKB TV. What a great job these guys have done. They were here hours before we were getting things set up tonight. Charles and Ronnie and Logan and all the gang from EKB TV. Great job tonight, guys. We appreciate you. But when we look at championships, Frosty, Jim sent me an email today. Trivia question. That's what the stinking genius does. He always challenges my mind.
Yeah.
But he sent me just a list of former Pikeville athletes and said, what do they have in common? Did you get the same email?
Yes, I did.
Did you get the answer correct?
I said too easy. Give me something. I knew it right off the bat.
I didn't think it was that challenging either. But the question was, these players had all played in state football championship games and been to the Sweet 16.
Mm-hmm.
And there was a list of current players.
Four.
That played for Pikeville's championship and now heading to the Sweet 16. And then you go back to the 1974 Sweet 16 right. appearance. And those guys as well. I was like you. It was too easy for those of us that live right, in right. that history. But for those that maybe don't know Pikeville's history as recently, you've got a list of those guys' names.
Yeah, and when you think about 100 years, Pikeville High School's been in existence and the success they've had, these eight players played in a football state championship and will now play in a basketball state tournament. Tommy Dale Clark, Greg McCown, Scotty Smith, the late Jimmy Newsom, and off this year's team, Wyatt Battle, Evan Rhodes, Mikey McDonald, and Braden Hunter.
How about that?
And I told Jim, I took it one step further. There's only one family, Andrew, that's played in football, basketball, and baseball state tournaments. And Mikey McDonald's brother, Scott, took care of that with the Final Four team. So the McDonald family has played in all three. I thought that was pretty neat. But, you know, and I don't know how he comes up with that stuff, but that was great. And I kind of took me down memory lane a little bit.
Exactly.
That state tournament back in 74.
Yes.
When Pipe went down, our head coach David Collier took him down there.
Mark
really
Myers.
Good ball club. And as luck or bad luck would have it, we draw the I thought it was the Boston Celtics.
Might as well be.
Louisville Mel, who had
Darryl Griffith.
Darryl Griffith, first-team sure. All-American.
Right.
Went on to Louisville, went on and had a 15-year career for the Utah Jazz.
Right.
They had Bobby Turner, another Division I player that played at Louisville. They had a 6'11 center by the name of Zach Adams. And, oh, by the way, their head coach was Wade Houston.
Right.
He went on to coach at the University of Tennessee.
Yeah.
But you had some great Jack Gibbons, James Lee played in that state tournament for Bryan Station. Kenny right. Higgs, Owensboro.
And, LSU.
And then you look up, and Louisville Central is the team that won it. So you talk about some good basketball back then.
Absolutely.
And then the 99 team, they went down to beat Boyd County the first game. Coach Thomas is principal now. And then they got beat by Ballard. So
who won?
It remains to be seen, the 2017 team, what are they going to write in the history books?
Indeed. And it will be decided. We're living history next week. We'll be there. We'll be on the air with the Panthers next week. From Rupp Arena on the air, WDHR, ESPN Radio, Hit City USA, and bringing you complete coverage of the Panthers' run at the Sweet 16. That's going to do it from Buffalo Wild Wings in Pikeville as we wrap up this championship edition of the Sports Guys. For Jamie Johnson, Jim Williamson, Frosty Davis, and all the crew at EKB TV, I'm Andrew Joyce. Good evening, everyone.
This is the Sports Guys Championship Edition.